Yes, I see. Good news, everyone!
What's up guys, Sal here. So it's been talked about a lot recently that the camera is going to be the main USP of the Galaxy S11. Samsung has been using the same camera sensor size ever since the Galaxy S7 days. They've been improving the camera experience through software. It's also been said that Samsung is finally ready to bump that camera sensor size on the Galaxy S11, but little we knew that they're gonna use the biggest camera sensor ever created for a smartphone. Yes, today we got an interesting nugget of information for the Galaxy S11's rear camera setup coming from none other than Ice Universe. He says, and I quote, "The Galaxy S11 has a high probability of using a new 108-megapixel sensor." For those of you who don't know, a couple of months ago, Samsung announced the world's first 108-megapixel camera sensor. It has a sensor size of 1 by 1.33 inches. To give you some perspective, here's an image showing the sensor size of flagship phones of 2019. As you can see, the Galaxy Note 10 Plus still uses a very small sensor of 1 by 2.55 inches, which Samsung used for the Galaxy S7. Huawei's Mate 30 Pro, which has one of the best cameras on the market right now, has a sensor size of 1 by 1.55 inches. If Samsung indeed goes on to use the 108-megapixel camera, then the Galaxy S11 will beat the Mate 30 Pro to the largest camera sensor in a smartphone. A lot of you would say higher megapixels won't mean better camera, and I totally agree. But the thing here is, this camera also has the biggest sensor. And we all know, bigger the sensor, better the camera, as it allows more light into the camera. Initially, I thought Samsung wouldn't go with this camera setup for the S11, since Samsung has the habit of using a 12-megapixel camera for their flagships. But it looks like it isn't the case this time. They're indeed going with this crazy megapixel camera. By the way, the Galaxy S11 isn't going to be the first smartphone to have this camera. Xiaomi already has one phone that has a 108-megapixel camera, and it's the all-screen prototype Mi Mix Alpha. Since no one actually got their hands on this prototype, we still have no idea how this 108-megapixel camera really is. But in any case, the camera on the Galaxy S11 is going to be better than what Xiaomi is going to be able to produce, because it's not just the hardware, but software plays a very big role in determining the image quality. Just ask Google. So Samsung released its earnings call for the third quarter of 2019, and it paints a great picture for their mobile division, and is courtesy of their latest flagship, the Galaxy Note 10. Their revenue for the mobile division was $25 billion, which is a 17% increase compared to last year. Their net profit was $2.5 billion, which is a commendable 32% increase from Q3 last year. Samsung is saying strong sales of the Galaxy Note 10 and also their Galaxy A series is the reason for this increase in revenue as well as the profit. Overall, Samsung made $53 billion in revenue and $6.71 billion in profit, because Samsung isn't just a mobile company. Anyway, for all the coverage of the Galaxy S11, do consider subscribing. And as always, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.